Hello students, today we will learn the various types of sets. The various types of sets are finite set, infinite set, singleton set, empty set and universal set. So first of all let us see what is a finite set. A finite set contains only limited number of elements. If the number of elements are limited in a set, we can say that that set is a finite set. For example, A is equal to set A, E, I, O, U. In this, the number of elements are limited. Therefore, we can say that it is a finite set. Now, another one is infinite set. In an infinite set, the number of elements are not limited, or we cannot find out the number of elements in them. In an infinite set. For example, A is equal to set of all the natural numbers. We usually denote the natural numbers by N, so we can say that N is equal to all the natural numbers, or we can say that W is equal to all the whole numbers, I is equal to all the integers, or set of all the prime numbers, set of all the composite numbers. All these are examples of infinite set. Now, next one is singleton set. If a set contains only one element, that set is known as a singleton set. For example, S is equal to set 0. It is a singleton set. We can also say another set, P is equal to set A. So all these are examples of, both of these are examples of singleton set. Now another one is empty set. An empty set is a set that contains, that does not contain any element. So empty sets can be denoted by two ways. We can say that A is equal to, without any element, we write a curly bracket, then it denotes an empty set. It can also be denoted by using the symbol phi. This symbol is read as phi. So these two ways can be, these two symbols can be used to represent an empty set. An empty set does not contain any element. Another one is universal set. A universal set is a comparatively larger set that contains all the other sets under consideration. In a particular situation or in a particular problem, suppose we consider two or three sets. If another bigger set that contains all the elements of those three sets, that bigger set is known as the universal set. The universal set can be denoted by either U or psi. This symbol is known as psi. These two symbols can be used to represent a universal set. For example, if we have two sets A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and B is equal to 5, 6, 7. The universal set can be considered as U is equal to 1, 2, 3 up to 10. All the members of A and B are inside the universal set. So it depends on the particular problem or particular situation. Now, the cardinal number of a set. The number of distinct elements in a finite set is known as the cardinal element of that particular set. For example, A is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. The distinct elements of this set are 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. They are 5 in number. Therefore, we can say that number of A, cardinal number is denoted by number of the name of the set. Number of A, number of B, etc. So, here number of A is equal to 5. This is the cardinal number of set A. Another example, B is equal to set P, Q, R. In this, number of A is, number of B is equal to 3. So this way we can define the cardinal number of a set. Now let us see what are equal sets. If two sets have exactly same elements, they are known as equal sets. For example, A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and B is equal to also 1, 2, 3, 4. both of these sets have equal number of elements and also the elements are also exactly same. Therefore, they are these two sets are known as equal sets. They can be denoted as A is equal to B. Another one is equivalence set. Let's see what this time. What are equivalence sets? Equivalence sets. If two sets have same cardinal number, those two sets are known as equivalence sets. For example, we can see A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and D is equal to A, E and O, U. Here A has 5 elements, number of A is equal to 5 and number of B is also equal to 5. Cardinal number of both the sets are equal, therefore these two sets are known as equivalent sets. Now, next one is subset. Let us see what are subsets. Consider two sets A and B. A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and B is equal to 1, 2. Here we can see that all the elements of B are also elements of A. All the elements of B contained in A, therefore we can say that B is a subset of A. This symbol denotes subset of B is a subset of A, and we can also say that A is a superset of B. If B is a subset of A, then A will be a superset of B. This symbol is known as superset of, and this symbol denotes subset of. Regarding the subsets, we have to note down the following points. If we have a set P, P is equal to 1, 3. If we consider the subsets of these sets, phi is a subset of the set P. That means phi is a subset of every set. And the set itself is a subset of every set. So you can say, if you want to write the subsets of this set P, the following are the subsets. First of all, phi, that means empty set, is a subset of P, and 1 is a subset of P, 3 is another subset, and also 1, 3 is a subset. So every set is a subset of itself, phi is a subset of every set, and also by splitting the elements we can make it various other subsets. So this way we can write down the subsets. Now let us discuss a few questions from exercise 5.2. In the first question, we have to classify the given sets as finite sets, infinite sets or empty sets. In the case of finite sets, we have to write down the cardinal number of those sets. See the first question, all the colors of rainbow. See the colors of rainbow are going to find, there are 7 colors of rainbow, therefore it is, and it is a finite set and the cardinal number is 7. Therefore we can say it is a finite set and the cardinal number is 7. Now, second one, x is a prime number between 7 and 11. Between 7 and 11 we know that the numbers are 8, 9 and 10. And these 8, 9 and 10 are not prime numbers. Therefore, there is no element in this given set.
Therefore, it is an empty set.
Now, third one, multiples of 5. Multiples of 5 means 0, 5, 10, 15, 20, etc. It does not end. So, an infinite set. Now, fourth one, all the straight lines drawn in a plane. If you take a particular plane, we can draw an infinite number of straight lines. Therefore, we cannot count those straight lines drawn in a particular plane. Therefore, it is also an infinite set. Now, set of all x such that x is equal to 4n, n belongs to I and x less than 10. Here it is given n belongs to I and x less than 10. Only if the positive limit is given, at the negative side there is no limit given. That means it extends to infinity towards left, towards the negative side, and therefore this is also an infinite set. Now, 8th question. X set of all x such that x is a prime factor of 180. For finding out this is also this is a finite set, but for finding out the elements of this set, we have to do the prime factorization of 180. Let us do the prime factorization of 180 here. Divided by 2, we get 90. Again by 2, we get 45. Now by 3, 15. Again by 3, 5. So these are the prime factors. 2, 3 and 5 are the distinct prime factors of the number 180. Therefore, we can, for convenience, we can write this set as in the roster form. That is 2, 3, 5. And it is a finite set. And the number of elements in the set is 3. We can write number of elements is equal to 3. So this way we can solve this kind of questions. Now question number 7. Write all the subsets of 2, 4, 6. This is the third question in 7. 2, 4 and 6. First of all, we know that 5 is the subset of all the sets. Therefore, 5 is the subset of this set also. Now, splitting the elements, 2 is a subset. 4, 6. Now, by taking 2 elements each, 2, 4, 2, 6, 4, 6. And we know that every set is a subset of itself. Therefore, 2, 4, 6. So, these are the subsets of the given set, 2, 4, 6.